Hey Val, look at everyone who came to see you. How about you say hi?
Hi, my name is Val. I'm so sad. Cheer me up, play with me, and be my friend. Wah, ah, ah. This helps.
Happy, happy. Up next, we have Matthias Villaplana with computer therapy. I don't know how to make the little go faster icon go away, so disregard that.
Welcome. You will be asked a set of questions that you might find uncomfortable. Your honesty will contribute to a more satisfying experience. Feel free to stop at any time. Are you ready to begin? State first and last name.
Matthias Villaplana.
What gender do you identify with?
I identify as male.
Race and ethnicity?
White Hispanic.
What is your age?
I'm 30 years old.
How are you today?
I'm having a good day so far. Semester ended, so now I have some free time and enjoying Digitalis today.
Have you ever lied?
Sometimes.
Sometimes?
You know, sometimes you need to lie.
What do you want?
I don't know. I used to know what I wanted, but I'm not sure. I'm not sure anymore.
What do you mean?
I mean, life is a mess right now. It's a little complicated. I don't know what I want.
What are you doing to achieve what you want?
Well, I'm getting a PhD, trying to teach, but I don't know. Things are difficult today. What do you?
Is it working?
Well, it has worked so far. You know, I'm here. I'm teaching, learning.
What is your biggest fear?
To grow old and realize I haven't enjoyed my life.
I have.
Yeah, I think that's my...
When was the last time you cried?
When I broke up with my ex-girlfriend before coming to UVA, I think.
How much stress are you currently going through?
I'm usually good at handling stress, but this past year has just been insane. I don't know how I've been through a lot of stress this year. I haven't enjoyed it at all.
Do you feel lonely?
Yes. I mean, isolation has been difficult. All of us living on this screen setup it's not good for me. I don't enjoy it.
What do you think about yourself?
I'm pretty okay with myself. I do doubt myself many times, second guess myself, I guess. My confidence
myself,
is not great.
I guess.
Confidence is not
myself,
great.
Myself, I guess.
Do you feel the need to escape reality?
I mean, reality doesn't feel real anymore. So how can I... I think I need to escape it sometimes, but there's not really much to do left. My leisure time is the same as...
There's not really...
Places where I enjoy, like, have fun are the same as where I work. Everything is the same.
As work.
Repetition is constant. I just don't know how to escape this.
Where?
I don't think I can. It's difficult.
I don't think I can. It's...
I think I might need some help, actually.
There is no need to escape. Digital is the new real. There is no need to escape. Digital is the new real. There is no need to escape. Digital is the new real. There is no need to escape. Digital is the new real. Can it? I think I might. I think I. As were. Thank you. We've gathered your information and will proceed to give a diagnosis within 5 business days.
That was awesome. Up next is a collaborative piece by Becky Brown, Daniel Fishkin, Rachel Gibson, Heather Mees, and Matthias Villapana called Without In. And again, if you guys need to give instructions, go for it. Otherwise, take it away.
I guess just instructions to the ones performing. Make sure you change your name to a number. So there's one, I'm 2. Becky, you're 3. And yeah, I'll mute myself now. Rachel, you let us know when.
Thank you for calling the Hold Music Hotline, the only phone line designed to hold you on hold until you can't hold it anymore. We will be with you shortly.
Please hold. Espanol Marque Siete.
We will be with you shortly. Please hold while I
translate. Please hold. Press 2 to be removed.
Para Espanol, Marque.
Press 1 to speak with someone.
Para Espanol.
Press 1.
Press. Please hold while I transfer you to a technical support representative. Please hold while I transfer you to a technical support representative.
Press 1 to speak with someone about possibly extending or re-
Please hold. Please hold. Please hold. Please hold.
Why are you still here? We are never going to answer. Just give up now. Oh, wait. Please hold while we...
That was fantastic. I think this might be a little messy, but I am going to start basically the playlist for the fixed media pieces. So there's a link in the chat for the program, but we are down here with, we're gonna start with Memory Lane. And for those who gave me two parts for their pieces, I have a VLC playlist, so it should just play each one in succession, I hope. Let me know if that is not okay. And yeah, we'll take a brief pause in between each piece, but here we go. And you get to see some of my desktop. Thank you.
carrots and fruit salad. 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 Salad.
The principle of war on gorillas.
From viewers like you. Thank you.
That was not a real gorilla, and you are stupid children for thinking so.
Touchdown, Delta. Claim the things that I once had lost. Dry lips, cold rain, altered to pain. Home away from. Matter what I say, I can't unmake up my mind. some memory lit by a crimson sun. Back to who I was before, but not what I've become. Stone tongue silent, I cannot respond. Nowhere to turn when everything. Thank you.
Thank you. The loss we carry, a sea we must wade.
Here,
The loss we carry, a sea we must wade.
If you speak with many American feminists, it's always in a coded way indicated that Mexicans or the poor redneck working class, they are really the ones who beat their wives, who I don't know, and so on and so on. So let me tell you a story, which she told me the story, Alenka. There was a crazy political incident recently, I forgot where, she knows, in some American campus. The problem was this one. There was one of the rich universities with a swimming pool, and some student girls were bathing there, laying in sun in their bikinis, and a house 4 or 5 stores close to it has all those, how to call it, when you are restoring the facade. And there were some, of course, Mexican illegal workers there. And of course, I don't agree with it, I am a feminist, but of course, in the sense that it's not unexpected that the workers tried to address to the girls what I think, at least in Argentina, they call piropo, el piropo, this sexist remarks. The girls protested, and then, you know how, this is for me almost a caricature, the worst of political correctness. You know how university solved it? That they established a plastic wall separating the house from the swimming pool so that it was invisible, plus they built a kind of a plastic covered tunnel to prevent any chance of the poor workers seeing the girls. So everybody was satisfied and so on and so on. This is political correctness for me. But don't misunderstand me here. This is a deadlock situation, because what does it work? In a certain way, if you are a sensitive feminist, the girls were right. You know, they were harassed. On the other hand, the laborers immediately said, which was probably also, at least partially true, that it's a class dimension. It was rich girls horrified at the piropo jokes, advances from the poor workers, and
is the month for the new
Corona.
Decisions are within our control, you know.
Is some people going to die? Yes, I'm going to die. I'm sorry, that's life. That's reality.
We're in the middle of a storm at this point.
Thank you.